Valley News Live, 10 at 10, continues with No Wait Weather.
Well, after a gray start to the day and soupy conditions for much of it, things quieted down this evening, and we were treated to a pretty fair evening by recent standards. 56 degrees right now at Hector International Airport, and the wind only 3 miles per hour. Moorhead, you have 55. Temperatures a little bit cooler where you see the greens in northern Minnesota. Lakes Country, 57 for Detroit Lakes and for Grand Forks this hour. Valley City, you're at that same reading. A little milder down to the south at 61 in both Gwinnett, and in the Sisseton area. Here is a look at the radar right now. We are starting to see some returns showing up in southeast North Dakota. The heavier rain that's likely reaching the ground out west on Interstate 94 near Dickinson, and South Dakota seeing some weather. As we take you in a little closer to the Southern Valley, we're seeing some green here on the screen, not far from Hankinson, not far from our live shot at the Dakota Magic Casino. Here's a look at that right now. And moments ago, there were raindrops falling through the light there, so a little bit of light shower activity in the far Southern Valley near the South Dakota border. Don't be surprised if a few of those drops make it down to your windshield tonight. But where the brunt of the activity is way down south. Southern parts of South Dakota, northern and central parts of Nebraska that have been under tornado and thunderstorm watches, and active severe thunderstorm warnings continue right now. And one active tornado warning here for this storm moving into the Clayton area, moving north and east right now. So all of this activity, very stout, very strong, but well to our south. Some of it is moving in our general direction. Your hour-by-hour forecast shows as we head to bed tonight. Temperatures will stay put, not far from where they're at right now. And as we go through the middle of the overnight, there'll be a chance of some scattered showers in our eastern South Dakota counties and maybe Richland County, maybe southern parts of the Otter Tail County area. Patchy, dense fog setting up once again as we start our day. Temperatures will generally be in the 50 to 55 degree range for most areas. And we start out, for the most part, dry, minus the drizzle and fog and low clouds, and those linger around through the midday hour. We'll notice more easterly wind in our southern counties, where you see Hutch's arrows crayoned onto the map here. Then as we go through the afternoon, a break in the clouds. The wind will be brisk, 15 to 25 miles per hour, and late in the day, an increasing chance for scattered showers and thunderstorms moving in from the west to the east. So a very good chance of rain Wednesday night and into Thursday. For your day in Fargo, Moorhead, 55 to start. Wind northeasterly, then easterly at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Temperatures peaking in the mid-60s with not much sunshine across the valley. Mid-50s in the far north, a lot of clouds building in late, and that late day chance of showers mainly after the nighttime drive. Rick Julian capturing an awesome photo here of a monarch butterfly on a beautiful flower in Park Rapids. Here is a look at your planning forecast. Wednesday night and into Thursday morning, we'll have a very good chance of rain, some of it quite heavy once again. Then, for much of Thursday afternoon, gusty winds from the north and from the west, over 40 miles per hour at times, will keep us on the cool side, although we'll still have a few sprinkles Thursday afternoon. It won't be an all-day soaker like Saturday was. Friday, we stay cool, but look at this warming trend, huh? I will take it. 70s and, yes, 80s are in the offing. One model saying we'll get up to the upper 80s, but not sold on that yet.
Well, we like that model. We'd like you to go with that model.
Oh, okay. We'll give it more consideration tomorrow.
Thanks, Ed.